All right, you say what you were saying.
All right, so realistically, what I think we need to do, and I know you're going to hate it, is I think we need to just forget about the premiere for now. Like, that'll have to happen at a later date. First and foremost, we need the money to finish this movie, because right now we're sitting in a spot where that might not even be possible.
It would be so fucking easy right now to get this fucking bread if we were cool enough with where we could market it. But yeah, we're not, and we don't have the product to deliver. And so we need to get the product done. Now, this is just like the most ego-shattering shit of all time that I have to call my dad and ask for help. But we actually kind of are in the position where that is right now, short term, our only option before launching the Kickstarter. So I have to call him on some business shit though, where I'm like, Dad, look, I don't want to fucking make this call, but can you front me like 20 G's so I can go finish my product and then fucking sell it and then give you the money tenfold afterwards? You'll be the first person I fucking pay back. And then we're just gonna have to see what he has to say. This fucking movie, dude. This fucking movie. Been broke twice making it. Fuck. Now I gotta ask for help. So, alright.
No, I know. It fucking sucks.
Alright, let's just call him right now. Fuck.
No one actually from Boston had ever made a movie in Boston.
My brethren, likely, keyword likely, the final theatrical showing of Apple Cinemas is going down here at the West Newton Cinema tomorrow night.
Apple Cinema just got picked up by a streaming service. Showcase now. It's also going to be coming online on YouTube on Tuesday, October 19th.
The interior. We'll give you guys a little tour real quick. What else we got in here?
Heated seats.
Heated seats. Ample room in the back for my bedroom out in Los Angeles. I gotta be honest with you guys, like, really hard to leave Boston. Really hard. It's a weird sensation leaving all your friends, all the people you love, the stuff you built.
Came out here to start working and meeting people in LA, and it's been a big failure, man. I have no fucking income right now. I haven't for a little bit.
Boom. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. This is Connor Hawley of the Golden Hours Podcast, and this is a quick live podcast. I'm currently scouring studios in Los Angeles to find a home for the show where we can start regularly having guests in the film and TV world. And so currently Armand, this is technically East Hollywood. We're in East Hollywood.
Okay, brethren, I met with Mr. Kung Fu Panda. Sweet guy, nice guy. Pitched him the podcast. Fucking landed it, motherfucker.
We've entered Zuvie Town, officially.
My first event in Los Angeles. Welcome to the Mini Zuvie.
Right now I'm scheduling emails for Monday the 10th. I found the emails of every Marvel producer I could find, and I'm inviting them to our event because you guys know my long-term goal is to produce a Marvel movie and be in a Marvel movie. And so I'm just trying to meet these dudes and use the leverage I have out here, throwing this big-ass costume party, and invite them.
My brethren, let me tell you guys something. There is gonna be some pain involved in this event tomorrow. Not as many people are gonna show up as I would have liked. I'm gonna lose a ton of fucking money. And I've been a soy boy about this for like 3 days, but I'm getting to this point where like I'm pretty grateful for it because, bro, I have just lost my fucking focus.
Found found the hypnotist, the great Dr. George Pratt, and I got hypnotized for success. And then literally in that 2-year span, became the best skateboarder of my entire career.
So Connor, just making yourself very comfortable, listening lazily to the sound of my voice. And the purpose of this exercise is helping you focus on what's important for you to accomplish in your project.
My plan right now is to really emphasize those meetups I have, where like I get people just in the entertainment industry together and try to find a deal with a bar here where I get a percentage of whatever revenue I bring in.
This is our 7th snake pit. Real quick, my name is Connor Hawley. I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I'm really just a hustler. In the coming months, Gavin, where are you? And Killian, where are you? These two gents, we're making a movie.
This morning, I get a text. It is my best friend, Jack Bigelow, with a young woman in a photo of an ultrasound. It's crazy, man. It's
cool. Yes.
Where's the dragon?
No, you don't have the money for that, man.
Rachel, this is a Dragons movie. You're the producer. Find us some money.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, man. I can do a Kickstarter.
Kickstarter.
Good idea.
Genius, actually.
I don't know why I didn't think of it sooner.
Let's do a Kickstarter.
Long story short, he's an incredible music producer, a really kind human. Phil, take it away, brother.
This is Phil here from Soul Snacks, checking in with my boy Connor, and I pledged to Conrad the Last Defender. Hit that Kickstarter with a quick fast, you know? Let's make it happen.
Shout out to my friend Connor Hallway again.
Please welcome Lindsay Lohan.
For launching the Kickstarter for his new film, Conrad the Last Defender. Go check out the Kickstarter, and all the best of luck to you, Conrad.
My brethren, huge news out of the Conrad camp. We just crossed the 60K mark on the Kickstarter. Fucking massive. Huge. We are making our project. It's gonna happen. We fucking hustled our way to get this, though. You bet that ass. There were no handouts with this fucking project.
This is Killian Dunn. Ooh. Give it a round of applause. Yeah. This is Gavin Anderson. Sorry, guys.
So, I think it sounds a little bit still too bright and, like, happy to work.
Lila, yep, just watch boom, it's low, so you should get up high.
Okay. Everybody ready?
I don't care if you're their father, like, you are destroying our lives more than your own by doing this kind of thing.
Yeah, I don't think that's a problem, Jill. I think that's a definitely not.
You ever need to pass the serial
killer? Hardworking man. Making a movie. Hell yeah, bro.
We have $15,000 in cash coming in a briefcase on a plane tomorrow to LAX that we have to pick up. And with that money, that extra money, we're actually able to go shoot this project. Without it, we're not. But it's literally $15,000 cash in a briefcase to make sure we get Conrad done. Just fucking crazy.
We've pushed so hard for so long. I would dream about doing shit like this in my basement.
Kill
the music.
Slate in.
Come on,
speed.
Boom, explosion. Nice.
So, at the time of this recording, I am currently adding footage into a folder so this whole documentary can get made. It is Wednesday, October 11th. We're planning our premiere about 50 days from now. And I'm gonna tell you guys right now, I don't have the money to do this premiere. By the grace of God, if you guys are seeing this on the side of the castle here, I didn't have money for this at the time. I don't have enough money to finish paying our director right now. Oh, it just sounds like a shit show when you fucking just start talking about it like this.
Hey, I'm Dane Cook, and I am voicing Derwin in Conrad, The Last Defender.
This is sick. Let's go.
And let me tell you, this guy means business. There's a pretty big battle happening out there in Bostonia right now. He and the Defender have been enemies since the dragons first took control of the world thousands of years ago.
Keep going, you're doing great.
Yeah.
How do you like the taste of my breath? Darrowin must kill Conrad, or else all of the dragons are fucked! And Conrad must kill Darrowin.
Bring it, Defender!
Huge call, brethren. Huge call right now. Fate of our movie, brother. Let's just fucking do it. Call failed. That's a motherfucker.
Say it again.
I said, I hope you're making money to live off on that, not for the movie.
I know it's making me stronger. Like, I know it's making me a bigger savage, and I'm gonna look back on this and be like, this is a hard time. I can handle this big shit easily, because that's what this does, is like, you rise to the occasion or you don't, but this shit is fucking brutal, Mom. It burns, Dad. It fucking burns, man. You know how much I've been fucking depressed and anxious in my life, but I fought through that shit.
I'm not gonna fucking quit, bro. You know how fucking disorienting this shit is? Like, 8 years in the game, it's like I can't even fucking pay rent next month. Like, what am I doing wrong, bro?
My brethren, that's it on the snake pit. It was big. It was fucking big. Biggest event yet, easily out here. And I am, again, the most classic fake until you make it story. Like, this is just blatant faking it until you make it.
This has been a really hard fucking year, man. I just want to accomplish these fucking things in my life. Just fucking show people I could do it.
But yo, it's been incredibly hard out there. Like, I've been broke twice, fully broke.
All right, Kill, this is the last shot of the doc. Yeah. I want you to do two things for me. Give me the date, the time, and then how you're feeling about shit.
It is 7:54, Monday, January 15th. We've been at this for months. It's been grueling. Some days have been chaos control, disaster control. Like, my fucking brakes blew out on the highway while I was driving my car. I didn't have any money to fix it. I had to, like, borrow money.
When you go to fucking Vons and Ralph's and you buy food, what's going through your brain?
Oh, man. I try to keep a $10 daily limit. $10 daily. So I'll go in there and I'll be like, okay. I treat it like a game. I'll be like, what can I buy for $10 that will fill me up for the entire day? And maybe even the morning. Maybe even the morning. So, yeah.
All right, you want to swap?
Yeah, let's do it.
So, January 15th?
Yeah.
January 15th, around 8 p.m., we are right outside the castle where you guys will be watching this documentary for the first time. Pan up there real quick, Kill.
If Connor 10 years ago, when roughly 10 years ago, when you started making YouTube videos, could see how far you've come, what do you think he'd say right now?
I'm not surprised I'm here, because these were thoughts I had when I was 16. I'm proud of myself for never fucking quitting, and you should be too.